This is the first year of Julian Rachlin and Friends in Mallorca. After 12 years in Dubrovnik, I want this to be a very colorful festival and spread in all different genres and directions. What makes it very special this year, this very first year in Parma, is to bring back the people who were coming for so many years to Dubrovnik, and after 5 years break, to sit down with them and to discover chamber music again together.
The friends and the colleagues on stage, that is what gets me going, and I think all of us, and that's why it's very special, this group of friends to come together, because I think we all feel that.
Of course, when you share stage with such wonderful musicians like this here, for example, and feel this communication, you feed from each other's excitement, and that's what makes it really so fantastic.
Julik is a special person, and he can create his atmosphere and produce his aura and energy wherever he goes.
It's such an amazing setup here. They're well organized. It's kind of the perfect place to escape and to play chamber music for a week. Immediately when we arrived, we all felt like family, like the warm invite, that it would be a joyous week of making music together.
This is one of the most famous holiday places in Europe. It is a magical island. We are playing in amazing venues. These are magical venues. 13th century, 15th century cloisters. I mean, this is a place full of ancient history.
Yesterday we were in the most amazing castle, open air, but such an acoustic. I mean, I'm looking forward to getting to know more venues around Mallorca and getting to know the island. Look at the audience here, so many young people.
Our goal is to open people's eyes, so to say, or ears and minds, and realize how wonderful experience it is to enjoy great music. And you don't have to be connoisseur in order to enjoy great music.
This is not only Julian Rachlin friends, but Julian Rachlin friends and family. And everybody also, even the friends, are also the family.
The success of each player here is absolutely astonishing. I mean, from the venue to the venue, from the city to the city. Reception is absolutely outstanding, and I'm sure people are more than happy to hear this amount, not only of big stars, but also great musicians, and to hear this kind of music. And I'm sure they'll be more than happy to hear them again, and maybe to expand the festival, to bring it to new places. I'm absolutely convinced.
I learned from Julian's festivals a lot, not only as a chamber musician, but also as a soloist. I'm sure that Mallorca and our festival has a great future together.
was so happy that I could make music with these musicians, this quality of musicians, the attitude, you know, this incredible enthusiasm. Mallorca has, at the moment, many more classic music fans who would like to go to concerts, especially in the summer. I think we could, you know, feel today how much people really appreciated the quality they're getting now with this.
Strong, great chamber music, great concerts with Shostakovich and pieces that are not maybe the most obvious. People that listen, they get so touched by it.
Julian and I decide to put together the festival back in Mallorca. We cannot imagine a better place, not only because of the people, the audiences, the weather, the food, which is very important for a type of festival like this.
Pablo Mielgo is not only an amazing musician and great conductor, but I think that he raised the whole level of the musical life in Palma. He made it happen.
Pablo's incredible. A great festival needs a great director to bring a certain soul and feeling, and so that everyone feels comfortable. Pablo is that for the orchestra here, and I think for the island. He's really the musical ambassador.
I'm so glad that Julian chose Mallorca. I'm so glad that this happened.
Come to JR and Friends.